the nerve of these 304s these days, man. The nerve, the unmitigated gall, the disgrace, all of those superlatives, adjectives, all of that. This is disgraceful, man. What is it with these athletes' wives nowadays? They want to talk. They want to have opinions. The celebrities' wives and girlfriends, they just make it their sole mission to make their man look weak, docile. They go out their way to do this. So here you have Matt Stafford's wife. It's not going to be the girl, not the brunette, but she's going to be the blonde haired chick, and she's going to talk about what she did to make Matt Stafford jealous when they were dating in college. Just take a listen what she did to make her then boyfriend, now husband of three or four kids now, but this is what she did to make him jealous back when they were dating in college.
Wait, so was he trying to casually date and you were all
in? Oh, yeah, girl.
Anyways, long story short, it wasn't that cute of a relationship at first. I hated him. I loved him. I dated the backup to piss him off, which worked.
Oh, yes. He was like, that'll do it.
He was the bad boy, too. Like, Matthew's so sweet and southern gentleman and all that stuff. And the backup was the complete opposite.
Yeah.
Ooh, and it upset him. So they lived in the same dorm because athletes lived in the same dorm, and he would see my car there. And so at one point, he like waited and followed me out and got in my car and wouldn't get out.
Oh,
and he was like,
this is so hot.
I was like, this is amazing. It's working.
Yeah.
I was get out of my car, and he was like, he's not right for you. And I was like, you can't tell me that.
Bitch, why would you tell us this? Why? This is something that maybe some family members know this. Maybe. What is it with? Now I'll say this. Her story isn't uncommon, believe it or not, because I think people think that athletes have this thing where they just mess with multiple women, and then they just go through all the 304s, and then the woman just obeys their every command, which is actually not really true. But a lot of the times what happens is even the Chads, right, the so-called Chads, the so-called Tyrones, particularly the athletes, can get greedy. So even if that one athlete is messing with multiple 304s, he'll like this one girl that he can't get his way with, and that will intrigue him because he's as a man, he's not like the rest of the regular dudes. So it will just nag at him that he can't get this one bitch. He can do everything right on the football field, but he can't get this one bitch to do what he say. So that will probably drive him nuts, right? But that happens to some athletes. That happens to some. So particularly like when you're talking about the conventional ones, right? So when you're dealing with a guy like Matt Stafford, who's probably old school, probably grew up traditional, you know, so guys like that, if they can't get their way with a girl, they'll struggle. They'll struggle and they'll do something stupid like that, like this, and marry a broad like this. You know what I mean? Because he you could tell Matt Stafford grew up in a traditional two parent household, blue collar family. I you can already tell, you know what I mean? So he probably thought, man, I'm just doing the right thing. I got to win this girl over, even though she's messing with this quote unquote bad person. Right. First of all, I got to look up because I do remember Stafford when he was playing in college. I got to look up who the backup QB was at the time. I got to look that up.
Wait, so was he trying to casually date and you were all
oh,
in?
Oh, yeah, girl.
Anyways, long story short, it wasn't that cute of a relationship at first. I hated him. I loved him.
So a lot of those relationships that you see like in college, it, particularly in college, if you're talking about a college relationship, even amongst the athletes and athlete and his girl, it'll be on and off between both of them, meaning they'll both be dating like multiple people on and off. And then they'll sometimes come back together. Then they'll break up. They both do their thing and come back together. So that's actually common in college. Just to let you guys know.
I dated the backup to piss him off, which worked.
Oh, yes.
He was like, that'll.
So we got to find out who in the hell was Matthew Stafford's back. This is crazy. Like if I was Matthew's, he plays for the Rams too, man. If I was a defensive end, forget his teammates, because I'm pretty sure he's lost the respect of some of his teammates because of what his wife did. If I'm like the Cardinals, right? The Rams. The Cardinals, the 49ers, the Seattle Seahawks. If I'm a defensive player on that team, man, I'll be talking mad shit. What? And I found out that, man, I'll tell you, boy, man, same with Steph Curry, right? And these people, backup QB. You see, look at this right here. one of the top trending things that is being searched on Google right now. A popular name that emerged was Joe Cox, who was one of Stafford's backups at Georgia. Man, yeah, if he go back, if Matthew Stafford come back to Detroit and he play, when he play against the Lions, they're going to be trolling this ninja, man. Man, man, man. So now, since it's, this is the problem with women and them talking. Hold on. I know that sounds crazy, but hear me out here. This is the problem with women and them talking. They don't understand collateral damage. They do not understand. There are certain things you got to keep to yourself. Is like the, they don't understand collateral damage. they do not under, like, they don't, they, I, yeah, they, it is official. They, like, women talk about they have emotional intelligence. They don't have, no, women have zero emotional intelligence. They have zero, what you call it, discretion. Even the hookers don't got discretion no more. This is why women don't understand, like, they, I know this, women do not understand collateral damage. Rams ain't going nowhere this season. Just to let you know. I know, well, I already, because Aaron Donald's retired, but it, yeah. They do not understand collateral damage. They don't understand the damage this is going to cause to his, first of all, her husband's ego, the respect that her husband get, the questions that they're going to ask her husband, right? Hold on, let me not put it on this broad here. Hold on for a sec. Let me not put this broad as the cover. We got to make sure we got this broad here. Matthew Stafford's wife. Let's put the picture of Matthew Stafford's wife up here. Because now you got, like, they don't... And I don't want to see no women in the comment section doing the same doing the same thing, right? That they did with the Steph Curry situation, where you had women, young women acting like, I don't know what Ayesha Curry said wrong. You just wow. And I told you, because of what Ayesha Curry did, it drove a lot of men to the space. People always talk about there's going to be a death of the red pill and all this. I'm like, look, women, they could cancel all of our channels, delete all of our stuff. Women are going to be women, bro. It's just going to be a new batch of dudes coming through with the information, because women are going to be women. Women are going to do women things, and dudes is going to be like, why would, people are going to have questions. Men are just going to naturally have questions. Women are going to do it to themselves. Oh, my God. And first of all, all this stuff about women liking good dudes and all that, we already know that's false, because here she admits it. Here she admits it. And she said that Matthew Stafford was a good dude, and to piss him off because if things wasn't going her way and blah, 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 she dated a bad boy to piss off a good dude that she had. The backup QB. Man, that's crazy.
Relationship at first. I hated him. I loved him. I dated the backup to piss him off, which worked.
Yes.
So that story short, it wasn't that cute of a relationship at first. We were all
Yeah, girl.
Anyways, long story short, it wasn't that cute of a relationship at first. I hated him. I loved him. I dated the backup to piss him off, which worked.
Oh, yes. He was like, that'll do it.
So this is toxic behavior, right? This is first of all, this is toxic behavior. And people are wondering, why would Stafford still, like I said, a lot of men grew up just thinking, I got to win over this girl, whatever. and like I said, the dudes that get punished are good dudes like Stafford, the good dudes like Steph Curry. Right. And I'm going to put my theory of this at the end, too. I'm going to get into that.
He was a bad boy, too. Like, Matthew's so sweet and Southern gentleman and all that stuff. And the backup was the complete opposite.
Yeah.
See, like right there, she already is proving all of our talking right there. So what are broads are going to have to say about this? I'm going to wonder how are they going to defend this one. I won't be shocked, but I am interested to see how women are going to defend this, because I was laughing when I saw women defending the Ayesha Curry, you know, saying you know, the Jada Pinkett stuff, Will Smith, right? You should have seen, especially when Will Smith lost his stuff, right? He lost his mind, slapped Chris Rock. Yeah, black women in there talking about this is black love, and you're just like, hey, yo, man, we done, bro. But I'm like, man, I don't know if there's any married men listening to this, but I'll say this. Fuck the money. I'm going to say F the money, F the fame. If I'm going to end up looking like this, looking crazy by a broad on a podcast, my wife, what? What? It's one thing your girl make, like a girlfriend make you look crazy, but my wife, what? Man, I'll tell you, men, if there's any married men listening to this, if you're making $40,000 a year, working at as an automotive tech, right? If you are car tech, right? If you change oil on cars and shit, and you do that and you think that's mundane, but you got a wife at home that's not disrespecting you in the streets, you're winning. You're richer than Matthew Stafford right now. You're richer than Steph Curry, Will Smith, any other athlete that's got a wife or a girl making him look crazy out here. You're richer right now than him. I'm telling you. And I'm not even the type to be like, oh, you know, I'm not even the type to be like, oh, you don't need money. Like, I'm the type to be like, no, you got to push for that money. You got to push for that money. I'm not even that kind of. But today, as we speak, nah, fuck that. If you work at, if you're HVAC, or you're a plumber, right? And you're not cracking 60, 70K a year, but you got a girl at home or a wife at home, right? And you decide to go that route, and she doesn't disrespect you in the streets. She doesn't talk about your sex life with her girlfriends. You are richer than most men. I'm talking about including these athletes. And I keep telling you guys, people just assume that athletes get the best girls. They don't. I'm telling you, the athletes don't get that same respect, especially in America. Especially in America, the athletes in America do not get the same the actual respect that they really deserve. And I got a theory behind this, because I talked about this last year. I don't know if you guys remember this. I dropped a video. I'll put the link in the description, when I talked about when Brady and Giselle were going through the divorce, and when people found out that Giselle was cheating on Brady. And I was trying to tell people, I just think the way we do sports in America, and this is a bit of a sidebar that I'm doing, the way we do sports in America, we have the wrong people as the face, right? Meaning, the stuff that we do when we overpay these quarterbacks in the NFL, and we say that they're the best players in the league, but they're not. They're clearly not. They're actually the most protected thing in the league, assets in the league, but they get overpaid way too much money, right? And what we do in America, we tell people who the stars are. We don't actually let it be shown and proved. Like in Europe, with their sports, there's promotion, there's relegation. You have to show and prove you're the best every year, or you get benched. You can be given a club perfect service for 10 plus years. If a young kid from an academy shows up and take your spot and he's better, he's just better. Got to move on. So already the way we do sport, I think women just I think women see this, in my opinion. I think women really see they see how we do shit here, and they're just like, they don't respect it, because they do things, they say things, they show things where they just don't respect the alleged top dogs of our things. Look at how they treat Negro basketball players here, right? Look how the straggles, the IG models, treat the black basketball players, right? Look how these quarterback wives be always having something to say, making their husband look crazy. Look at what these actors, a Jonathan Majors, right? Or these people, when they're dealing with a girl. But I'd be looking in Europe, and you're starting to see some of the nonsense seep in Europe now. But the guy will be like 5'8", 5'9", and right, 5'7", and their girl don't be doing that. You know what I'm saying? Messi's girl don't be doing that, right? How about this? I'll say that this is why I respect LeBron James. Because when you look at LeBron James' family, right, compared to Steph Curry's family, when you see Steph Curry's kids acting up at the press conference, right, in 2015, 2016, and I'm just looking at that, and then I'm looking at Ayesha Curry tweeting her ish, when she had some Twitter, her eager Twitter fingers, right, making Steph Curry look bad. And I'm like, that family, they don't respect him. I could just, and then compare that to LeBron James. And then you have LeBron James' family at the podium, right? And he's brought his kids, and they're in obedience. maybe I'm a weirdo for noticing stuff like that. But to me, When I saw stuff like that, it made me respect LeBron more, even though I wasn't even a fan of LeBron like that. I'm telling you, when I saw stuff like that, when I was in high school, I was just like, you know what? LeBron runs his house. He runs his house. That matters, guys. I'm telling you, that matters. Even Like, because now you're seeing Savannah now coming out with a podcast and you're like, oh, God damn it. But she hasn't said anything out of pocket yet. And people are just holding on. They're just holding on to the hope. You know what I mean? But I just remember during that time, I was just looking at LeBron James' family compared to Steph Curry's family and like other families. And I'm like, LeBron got his family on lock. And that made me actually respect him more as a basketball player. It's crazy how that works. But that's how important that part is. And you actually being the top dog, like a LeBron James, who really is the top dog. He is a top dog. So there's a difference. There's just a difference when you're actually that guy compared to when the media is just like, okay, this is your star, America. And they're just like, him? Oh, okay, if you say so. And I think it seeps in. That respect just isn't there for certain male athletes in America. But that's just my aside on that end. But bottom line, Matthew Stafford's wife, man, I mean, bruh, are you kidding me? Why are you doing this now? Why are you doing this to this man now? He does not deserve this.
Yeah. Ooh, and it upset him. So they lived in the same dorm because athletes lived in the same dorm and he would see my car there. And so at one point he like waited and followed me out and got in my car and wouldn't get out. And he was,
by the way, that buzz, that's not from me. That's from their techs. So whoever's running the sound system at their little podcast thing, whatever they, what was it called? Off the Vine podcast. They got to fix that.
You're like, this is so hot.
I was like, this is amazing.
That's just wild, man.
Yeah. I was get out of my car and he was like, he's not right for you. And I was like, what? You can't tell me that.
But like I said, them Karens, they turn on you real quick. They mad. Like, I'm telling you, like, when you know, Kelly Hall, I bet you she was some hot stuff when she was in college. You know what I mean? Even though there's a lot of hers. You know what I mean? But I'm telling you, man, that like what she doing, that's just wild. And I'll say this. I'm gonna have to call out some of you dudes in the comment section. I don't know if I can find it, but people are talking about, oh man, I understand what OJ was going through now. And you're just like, the nerve of you guys, y'all put OJ Simpson through hell. And I was telling y'all don't know what was going on with that situation. When you're dealing with a disrespectful broad and the situation with like for them to still like reference Ron Goldman's son as a male friend. They still reference him as a male friend. That's how embarrassing this stuff is. This is embarrassing. You know what I mean? But like I said, oh, Jay's guilty and he had no right to. Look, I already told you my opinion on that situation. I don't think he did that by himself. And there's a good case to make that he probably didn't do it. But people were just too, I believe black people and white people were way too caught up in the race part and they don't understand the aspect of a bitch being a bitch part. And for some reason, people miss it because men are simps. And they don't ever want to put it in a context of where a broad being the X factor of the whole situation. And you could just eliminate that part. And you're like, oh, okay. I see what happened in this situation. But like I said, people are way too caught up in the race part of it. They don't even understand the human aspect of just the situation between OJ, the broad, and the broad side team, Mr. Goldman. And I look at this tweet right here. It says they have four daughters together and their mom is still going around talking like this. Embarrassing. But like I said, that mentality, it doesn't stop. It just doesn't stop.